Yeah, hi there, and welcome back. So let us continue with our lesson. And today we'll go and add an overflow menu. So overflow menu, we want to add over here, and we'll add some item for that particular menu. So let's go and get started with it. So first of all, I'll go to the rest folder over here and go to the menu. And over here, I'll create a new menu resource file, and I'll just give a name as a main menu and a main menu. And you can give it any name. It depends on you what name you want to provide. So I'll just give a name as a main, sorry, M-A-I-N, main menu, and just copy it later. I want to use that one. So it will create a menu resource file for us, and I should go to the design. And now let me add a menu item. Just drag and drop over here. So let us add a two menu item. And let us give our item name as first as edit. And for the second one, we will make use of our delete. This will be for the delete. And we also need to provide the ID. So let us give our ID as a main menu of, this should be of edit. And this will be of a main menu of delete. So we have that one, and it's giving you some error. So for that, we need to add a string resource file. So let us extract the string resource. And I can just give a name as a main menu underscore edit for the edit. And for the delete, I will extract it and give a name as, it should be of our main menu underscore delete. Just click on OK. Now you can click on the control from your keyboard, and it will give, when you put your cursor over here, it will give you a link. Just click on that one. It will take you to the string resource file. This is the file that we just created. And since we have our menu ready, so we have a edit and a delete menu. So what we will do is we need to show that particularly over here. So let's go to our main activity. You can also add that particular menu on the fragment. So we have a three fragment. So if you want to show that on only on the dashboard fragment or home fragment or notification fragment, you can add it over here. But we are not interested on this particular fragment. Let us add to the main activity. So all of our dashboard, home fragment, as well as the notification have the same item, a menu item. So let me open this main activity, and from here I need to override some of the, let me override two functions. So on option menu, so I have on create option menu, this is the one I need to override, and another one is on option, option item something, so on option item selected. So this is the two functions that I need to override, and after that I can inflate the menu. So it should be not the layout inflator, it should be of a menu inflator, sorry for that one, that's why I got confused. And inflate, and I will just copy this one over here and paste it over here. Not the layout inflator, it should be of a menu inflator. On reachable code, so it should be, I need to comment out this one first. Let us comment out this one, and after here I can just return that one, return true, or else you can return the same over here. Just copy this one and paste it over here. And now if you try to run your application, you should get that particular menu displayed in your home or the home fragment. And let us wait for the application to come up. And now if you check over here, we have a small three dot over here that is an overflow menu icon. And if you click on that one, we have a edit and a delete. So when we click on it, nothing is happening because we haven't set up the on item selected over there. And when we go to the dashboard, we have the same. And when we go to the notification, we have a same overflow menu. This is because we have added to the this one to the main activity. So when we add it to the main activity, so all of our fragment that we are having in our the navigation. So if you go to the navigation graph, so we have added all of this to the main activity, which hosts the fragment. So that's why it's showing up in all of the fragment. But you can also do it the same way for the particular fragment. So if you just want to add into the particular fragment, you can just add in over there. And now the next thing is that we need to add over here the on option item selected. So this is the next option that we have to set up. So let's go and do it. And for that, let me comment out this one for now. And what we will do is we will use a when. And when I will say as item.id. So we need to get the ID of the particular menu item. And here I will just say r.id.main menu. So we have a main menu of edit. And when it is of this one, we can, whenever it is clicked or item is selected, that then we want to do something. So I'll just leave for empty for now, and let us do it for the r.id.main delete. So main menu delete, and this should be the one. And I can just remove, copy this one and return below over here. So we have this particular two. Whenever this item, the menu item over here, you can see the menu item, and we get the ID, and we get the ID of that particular menu item. And whenever it is clicked, we want to do something. So let us add a toast, or we can add a snack bar. So SNACK snack bar dot make. So let us add a view. So we get we add a view over here. So get a content view, or let us add a view as we need to go to the main activity. So main activity, and let us get the view from here. So view ID, I'll just say as a main layout. And let us get this ID over there, snack bar, and I'll just give over here, so main layout. And here we will show that the edit menu, it's yellow clicked. And we have another option to go. So duration, SNA snack bar dot, we have a length of a long dot, I will show that one. And I'll just copy the same thing and paste it over here. So this should be of the delete menu is clicked. And let us go and run our application. So let us wait for the application to come up. And let's go to this particular edit. And now we can see that edit menu is clicked. And when we click on the delete, it will give us a delete menu is clicked. So which means that our menu item is, overflow menu item is working correctly. So if you go to notification and you click on, we should get the same edit menu is clicked. So depending on your requirement, you can add a click listener, and you can do whatever tasks you want to perform over here. So whenever the delete is clicked, you can just go and delete your item. Whenever edit is clicked, you can open up another activity or a fragment to edit that particular item. So all of this can be done. So I hope you enjoyed this lecture, and now we learned about the overflow menu in this section. So let's meet up in the next lecture. Till then, have a great day.